How are you doing? You just left the hospital last night.
We're getting there, you know. Glad to be out, and just compared to how my friends are and stuff, it's, like, you know, it's as bad as it is. I can't complain. It's just, I was 6 inches away from being the same way as them, losing limbs and stuff like that. I just was fortunate enough to have the mailbox take most of the impact from the lower half of my body. The rest of the shrapnel, you know, anything above the height of the mailbox is what caught in the face, neck.
So where were you standing? This was in relation to the first explosion?
We were at the second explosion.
You were at the second explosion.
Yes, and there was, right where you see the picture where they show the backpack and the mailbox, right. That's exactly where we were.
So you were to, if you're facing the mailbox, you were to the right of it?
Just to the left of it. They were to the right of it. Okay. So that's why they suffered the, you know.
So the shrapnel that hit you is shrapnel that came over the mailbox?
Came over as BBs, nails. It's what they, you know, my friend had 70 nails in his leg. And
70 nails?
70 nails. And, you know, I have BBs. There's still one in my neck that the doctors couldn't take out because it's too close to my nerves to control my vision. Mm. And most of them in my face came out, you know, due to the surgery and stuff like that. And just burns. I mean, it burnt the clothes right off of us.
Your clothes were actually burned off here?
Burnt right off of us. Just indescribable.
Do you remember the blast?
I remember everything about it.
Really?
Yep.
Can you walk me through? I mean, what stands out?
I mean, the first explosion went off just down a block from us, and
did you know something was wrong then?
We knew it wasn't something to do with the marathon, and you know, we were ready to get going and get out of there, and our friend, you know, Jared, he said, "Let's get the girls over the fence." And just as he said that, is when the explosion hit. It blew me over the fence into the street and stuff.
Actually carried you over.
It carried me over, and just the force and the heat and the burn from it, the chemicals from the bomb, were just had me on fire and everyone else. And as I came through, just in the days of, you know, what was going on, just looking for my friends and stuff like that, and it was just absolute chaos. You know, I saw things that, you know, I wish I didn't see. You know, people losing limbs and just stuff. It was bad.
Could you hear anything after the explosion? I've talked to some people who said they couldn't hear anything. They could see people's lips moving, but they...
It was like in the movie The Town when the flash grenade went off, and all you could hear is that high pitch noise, and that's all that it was. And it's like it was in slow motion, just seeing what was going on. But, you know, half the people ran away, and then the other half of the people ran to help. So it was amazing to see the amount of people that stood by us to help us out, and just... It was catastrophic, just the way, I mean, just to know what was going on and not knowing where anyone I came with. You know, four out of my five friends lost their limbs, and literally
four out of your five friends.
Yeah, it's just, and we're all very close friends. I mean, her two brothers, I know the family well, and they're like brothers to me. I love them to death, and I wish the best to everybody. Our friend Mark, thing, you know, he lost both of his legs, most likely, or no?
One.
He's borderline with that, and just pray to God that he, you know, pulls through and just... We were having a great day and waiting to see our friend cross the finish line, and then all of a sudden just it turned in a flash.